Joining us now is Senator David Perdue. Senator, good morning. Thank you for being here.
Good morning, Sandra.
So how did the resurfacing of that video change things?
It really doesn't, and neither did it last weekend when it came up to start with. Look, Sandra, this is a flawed process. The articles that were sent to us from the House are nothing more than poison or fruit from a poison tree. The process in the House was illegitimate. It's inappropriate. They denied due process. And frankly, right now, the Democrats have come over to the Senate. They've harassed us, calling us co-conspirators in a cover-up. They call the defense team liars. And what they want us to do now is what they should have done during their investigation. They should have called these witnesses and back when they had the responsibility.
But Senator, looking back, heading into this process, I did see that you were open to witnesses if there was the need to hear from additional witnesses. So what have you seen play out in that impeachment trial that has led you to believe that no witnesses are needed?
Well, let's clarify that. What I said was any witnesses that are already in the record, there are 17 witnesses that the House called, they haven't even requested any of those witnesses. And so my view is if we wanted to clarify something from an existing witness, that's fine. There's no they've already done depositions and so forth. What I'm saying is we can't go outside the scope of what we've been given. Our charge in the Senate is to rule on the articles that have been brought to us. These two articles, as we've heard over and over this week after eight scintillating days here, is that the articles are not impeachable. And more than that, the House managers have not proven their case.
So when it comes to the votes that are needed to block calling additional witnesses in this trial, do you believe that Republicans have that?
Well, I'm optimistic. I mean, it's the right thing to do. It's a bad precedent because what happens if we fall into that Pandora's box? Sandra, we could set a precedent for future impeachments where impeachments are initiated in the House with very little investigation. They're sent over to the Senate in a rush form, just like they have been here. And then we're required under this president to call witnesses and so forth. There's a reason the founders didn't want that. They wanted the investigation to be done in the House because they could do it in committee without shutting the House down. In the Senate, under an impeachment process, as you can see from the last 8 days, we can't do anything else. It totally shuts the Senate down. And that's what this is about. Chuck Schumer wants to shut the Senate down because this is about the Senate majority and getting the White House in 2020.
We are going to hear from Chuck Schumer in a couple hours from now. He's going to be holding a press conference. So we will see what he's saying this morning. Meanwhile, it wasn't just that John Bolton video. It was also an Adam Schiff video, who is lead impeachment manager now. It's a video from May 2005. And after it resurfaced, the president is now claiming game over. Let's listen to that together.
Particularly given the history where we've had the politicization of intelligence over WMD, why we would pick someone who the very same issue has been raised repeatedly, and that is John Bolton's politicization of the intelligence he got on Cuba and on other issues. Why would we want someone with that lack of credibility, I can't understand.
So then it was a lack of credibility, and now he is declaring him not only a believable and important, but an extremely relevant witness in this trial.
Senator, that's just the latest example of the total hypocrisy we hear from the House. We have an overwhelming case, and yet now we need more witnesses because we can't prove our case. I mean, the hypocrisy from the Democratic man. By the way, they're the Democratic managers. Let's be very clear. This is not a House manager situation. This is not a bipartisan effort coming out of the House, which the founders warned us about. Alexander Hamilton talked about it repeatedly. This needs to be an extreme case. It needs to be bipartisan. And the House has just not done it that
way. Your colleague, Senator Van Hollen, Chris Van Hollen, he believes that it is impossible not to summon John Bolton to testify in this trial. And he put this tweet out. I'll get your reaction, Senator. On Friday, I plan to offer a motion that will require Chief Justice John Roberts to, one, subpoena witnesses and documents if he determines that they are relevant, two, rule on any claims of executive privilege in order to expedite the trial. To that, you say what?
Well, the judge is not going to do that. But more importantly, it's another attempt to prevaricate and to throw confusion into the process. This is very simple. They have brought over two very serious accusations, which, by the way, neither rise to the level of impeachment. And even with that, they didn't prove the case. And therefore, our job now is to adjudicate that. We don't need any more information to make a ruling on the two articles of impeachment that have been brought to us, period.
Senator Brasso says, I'm ready to vote on final judgment. Do you believe Republicans are planning to move directly to vote on these two articles of impeachment as soon as tomorrow, Senator? Final thoughts?
Well, I sure hope so. We're working hard to make it that way. Look, this is shutting the Senate down. We've heard all the evidence now. It's become very repetitive, as you could see last night. It's time to move to a vote on acquittal as soon as possible.
Senator David Perdue of Georgia, appreciate your time. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.